it's Jessie V, and I have to show you the shirt that I'm wearing today. It's so funny. Okay, so it says the Cryptid Mash. Do you get it? Like, instead of Monster Mash, it's Cryptid Mash. Urban Legends. Did you get it? Anyway, I thought it was funny, so I wanted to wear it. But funny things aside, this video is actually a pretty serious one. As you could tell by the title, we're gonna be talking about kids and young people who disappeared on Halloween. Some of these people were found again, some of them were missing forever. And I think two of the stories are completely real, and the other two might be creepypastas. I'm not entirely sure. And the first one I'm gonna tell you is real. This is the disappearance of Stephen Damman. On Halloween of 1955 in New York, a woman named Marilyn DeMann took her 2-year-old son Stephen and 7-month-old daughter Pamela to the supermarket. Now, she left both of her children outside of the grocery store while she went shopping. She was just doing a very brief errand, and her youngest daughter was actually in a baby carriage because she was only 7 months old. But minutes later, when the mother returned from running her errand, she saw that her children were gone. The carriage with her daughter inside it was found a block away, but Stephen was never seen again. So for some reason, her youngest daughter was completely unharmed just down the road. So it's strange how she was left there just fine, but Stephen was just nowhere to be seen. The police were investigating this case and weren't able to find anything, so it went cold. But decades later, in 2009, a Michigan man came forward to police saying that he himself was Stephen, the boy that went missing back in the 50s. But the police did a DNA test on this random man and they found out he was lying. But nevertheless, it was very strange how this man really truly believed he was Stephen. So yeah, this case remains a complete mystery. No one really knows what happened. There were no witnesses to see what went on outside the grocery store. And it just blows my mind. I mean, I would never leave my young kids outside on their own. I know things were so, so different back then. Things were a lot safer, if you can believe it or not. But there are just too many evil people in this world. I would never leave my kids alone. And when I was little, I would never leave my mom's side. Like, remember that horrible feeling you got whenever you lost your parents in a store? Like, you literally thought you were going to be lost forever. All right, this next disappearance story is called The Girl That Followed the Pumpkin Man. This happened back in the 80s on Halloween morning. There was this mother who had these two daughters. One was 7 years old and the other one was 4. They didn't have school because Halloween fell on a Saturday, and the mother wanted to quickly go to the store to pick up candy for later on. So she told the girls to stay inside and just watch movies while she was away. She only expected to be about 30 minutes. When she got back and walked into the house, she saw that her youngest daughter was crying hysterically and noticed that her older daughter was nowhere to be seen. And when she asked her younger daughter what happened to her older sister, she got the eeriest response.
"She followed the pumpkin man into the forest,"
she said as she pointed to the window looking into their backyard. Their house backed onto a very large forest, and the girls were always told to never go into it without an adult present. Now, obviously, this mother was extremely confused about what her daughter was telling her, and when she tried to get more information, she found out that there was literally this man standing in the forest with a pumpkin over his head, probably some sort of Halloween costume, and he was like beckoning the girls to follow him into the forest. Now, the youngest one was too afraid, but the older daughter wanted to go because she was curious. Now, don't worry, there's actually a relatively good outcome to this story. The girl was missing for about 2 days, and then police eventually located her. When they asked her what happened, she also said,
"I followed the pumpkin man and got lost in here."
And to this day, they have no idea who this person was and what his motives were, because the girl was found completely unharmed. And guys, this might just be a creepypasta, because I couldn't find any like real dates or real like newspaper articles about it. So if you guys know if it's real or fake, definitely comment down below. But this Halloween, if you see a man standing somewhere with a pumpkin mask on and he's doing this motion, don't follow him. Don't follow him. All right, so this next missing case is called Vanished Without a Trace, and this is completely real as well. To this day, no one knows what happened to a girl named Cindy Song. She was a grad student at Penn State University who disappeared without a trace after leaving a Halloween party after midnight in 2001. Now, on her way home from this Halloween party, she actually stopped at one of her friends' houses. It was in the early, early morning, probably like 1 or 2 in the morning. She was wearing a bunny costume, and apparently she got a ride home back to her house at 4 a.m. Now, here's the strangest part that cops just can't understand. She managed to get inside her home safely, and she dropped off her belongings, including her backpack, her cell phone. She even removed her false eyelashes. So she literally got home from this party just fine, got into her house, and was literally getting ready to go to bed. But after this night, she was never seen again, and nobody knows what happened. Investigators found no evidence of foul play. They found no suspects, so this case is completely cold. It's just so strange how all of her stuff was in her house, all of her doors were locked. It was like she just disappeared into thin air. So yeah, I guess the moral of the story here is definitely be careful when you're going home on Halloween, especially if you're alone or it's super late at night. And I guess that also applies to generally any night. But yeah, this story was extremely sad, and it's especially sad when you don't have any answers. This last story is called the Ghost Blanket Mystery. I'm not sure if this one is real or not. It definitely could be. This story takes place back in the 90s on Halloween. There was this group of three teenagers who went out trick-or-treating around 9 p.m. and were never seen again. Now, around midnight, their parents were obviously very worried, so they called the police and told them that their kids had not come home. Now, because these were teenagers who had gone out, the police told the parents to kind of just wait a bit longer because maybe their kids were out pulling pranks, were up to no good, or maybe out partying. So the police told the parents to wait until the morning to call them. Well, the morning came around and their kids were still not home, so the police decided to start an investigation. Basically, the entire neighborhood was involved in the search, but they couldn't locate them anywhere. So the police started interviewing everybody in the area to see if they saw anything weird the night before. And here's the eeriest part. Almost all the people the police were interviewing saw the same weird thing on the Halloween night. Parents had noticed a tall person dressed in one of those ghost blanket costumes. They said the figure was tall enough to look like whoever it was well over 30 years old. And it was just like following people around, watching people trick-or-treat, but they never walked up to houses to get any candy. Apparently, some parents even walked up to this weird person asking them what they were doing. Because as parents, when you see something weird, especially when you're with your kids like trick-or-treating, you're gonna wanna confront it and make sure everything's okay. But anyone who talked to this person said it never responded. And it's crazy how many people pointed out this mysterious figure to the police, but when the police went to find this suspect, they had no luck. And this whole thing is still a mystery to this day. These kids were never found. There was no evidence. It was like this person who was wearing this strange ghost costume just completely disappeared. It's always so tough reading about cold cases because when you don't have answers, it's so bothersome. And actually, this figure reminds me of that new TikTok challenge that's going around where people have to put that like ghost blanket over their heads and like take pictures in interesting locations. I kind of wanted to try that, but after reading the story, I don't know. Anyways though guys, those are all the stories I'm going to be talking about today. Obviously there have been so many more disappearances on Halloween, but a lot of those stories are just too gruesome and I would not be allowed to talk about them on YouTube, so I only mentioned the ones that I knew I could talk about. But obviously you can do your own research in your own time. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Don't forget, if you want to win this backdrop behind me, all you have to do is go and follow my TikTok account called OfficialJessieV. Go like videos, comment on them, and if I see your name pop up a lot, I will pick you to win. And if you guys would like the new That's So Creepy shirts, I will definitely link them down below for you, and I hope you have an awesome rest of your day, and I will see you in my next video.